When we think about SEO and accessibility, it's easy to focus only on individual pages, but there are a few settings that apply to your entire site that are just as important. So in this lesson, we'll look at the global site settings in Framer that help ensure your site is both search friendly and usable by everyone. We talked earlier about how to set titles and descriptions at the page level, which can help search engines and users understand what our content is about. But Framer also lets us set site-wide settings, and this plays a key role too. If we click on the settings icon in the top right corner, we'll drop into the general tab within our site's settings, where we're able to customize our site title, language, description, and more. And just like in the page settings, Framer gives us a preview of how this information will appear in search results. Some of these global settings act as a fallback in case we forget to customize things like the title or description on a specific page. Framer will use this site-wide version instead, ensuring even overlooked or secondary pages still show up with meaningful info in search results. It's a simple way to maintain consistency and add clarity where there otherwise might not be any. Right next to our site title, we'll see our site language, which screen readers actually rely on to correctly pronounce content, and translation tools used to determine how and whether to offer translations. Without it, assistive tools might misinterpret the content completely. It's also a signal to search engines, helping them serve your content to users in the appropriate region or language. Now, let's talk about something important that you may or may not know about: motion sensitivity. Some users can experience things like nausea, disorientation, or even fatigue when exposed to excessive motion on websites, especially auto animations, parallax effects, or scroll-based transitions. Framer gives us a way to respect and acknowledge that by allowing these users to enable reduced motion by clicking the checkbox next to disable movement animations and custom cursors if the user prefers reduced motion. When this is checked, the site automatically responds to a user's system preference and tones down animations on the site. It's not just about accessibility laws or best practices, it's also about being thoughtful for the user. It's a small step that makes a big difference in creating a comfortable, inclusive experience. Okay, so a quick recap. Titles and descriptions set at the site level provides a fallback for pages that don't have custom titles or descriptions, so no page gets left behind in search results. The language attribute helps search engines and assistive tech better understand your content, especially for international or multilingual audiences. And motion preferences ensure that users who need reduced animations get a smoother, more comfortable experience. These global settings don't replace the need for thoughtful page-level optimization, but they do give your site a safety net, making sure every page is usable, understandable, and discoverable as it scales. Remember, the best user experiences aren't just built at the page level. They're always backed by site-wide thoughtful decisions. So, in the next lesson, we'll go over how to test and validate everything we've implemented so you can launch your site with confidence, knowing your SEO and accessibility setup is solid. See you there.